Good morning. I don't even know what it is. Day three, day four. So we decided to rip up the floor quickly and put a special layer on it. So we've just taped it all up. Alrighty, so I've actually just put the flooring in. Apart from that inspection hole, I gotta make that board a little bit smaller, and then I'll cover it and then countersink it, and I will seal it because this doesn't really get used. It goes in for the fuel pump. Otherwise, yeah, it doesn't look too bad, but man, anybody said that laying tiles and flooring and everything else is easy? Nah. I was going to film it, and then I decided, no, I don't think you want to see me swearing all the time. But I have finished off with a nice trim, and I've still got a, I've run out of trim, but I've put it over there on that door. So it's looking nice. I bought some cabling, and what we're going to do is I have a USB that has to be here. There's going to be two lights over here. Sirocco fan, so that's at least three cables going all the way through, and then quite a few other bits and pieces that I want to do. I'd rather at the end have more than enough of power supply, and it's always there, so probably overdoing it a little bit, but yeah, once the cables are in, then I can actually start. I'm going to cut 80 mil strips all the way across and mount them against the roof, and then start bringing the cables down over here. Right by the door is going to be the fuse box inside, because the Bluetti is going to be put there by the door, so I'll be running a cable straight from the Bluetti through to the fuse box, which is a 35 amp connection. So then I've still got 240. I want to put a plug over here of 240, a pop-up plug in the kitchen, so you press it and it'll actually come up. There will be three plugs, and then maybe a cigarette lighter over there as well, just in case we need extra light or anything else. So yep, that's exactly what I'm going to be doing today. I'll do a little bit and then show you, and do a little bit more and show you. Rather difficult sometimes to have the camera on while you're trying to actually do work as well. So here goes, catch you soon. Right, so let me show you what I've done. So far I've put a USB and cigarette charger over here with the cables going all the way up, and then they will come down to the fuse box over there. I just bought this at J-Car, so a cigarette and USB. So the great thing about this is I've always got power over here regardless, whether it's for an awning lights, whether it's just it would be more of a spare, but I don't want to run cables all the time just because I forgot to do something. So I may be doing a little bit more than what I should, but I'd rather actually have it and then battle after everything has been already laid out and things like that. So we got two lights over here coming up. I'll do the cabling, but I'll just run it to over here so that we can bring it behind the board, and the ceiling fan. So there'll be another two cables going through to that side. Over here there will be a board coming right up, and that's where I'm going to put a 240 socket and then run it all the way through to the Bluetti. Fan I will reconnect and bring it all the way down now. And yeah, let's take it from there. One step at a time, guys. One step at a time. Hello, you two.
Sit.
Stay there. Shadow, what do you think of the... Shadow.
Shadzi.
Talk. What do you think of the place?
Shady.
Hey, what do you think of the place so far? Talk to me. Shadzi, talk. Talk. What do you say? What do you say? Sit down. Sit.
You'll come back when you can find some peace. Cause every word that I've heard spoken since you left feels like a hollow street.
Right, so it's actually pretty easy. You get a whole lot of brackets. The biggest thing is read on these, like front left, front right. Middle left, middle right, back left, back right. So you need to know and make sure that every single one is in the right position. And what you do is you remove these brackets, stay on, and you don't touch them. Just remove this. Right, so that goes in. There you go, it goes in like that, and then it gets connected. I'll show you. And then they're talking about, oh, it's got to be on 7.5 newton meters strength, or the torque. And how the hell am I going to actually do this? Lo and behold, they give you the tools, so you have a little torque wrench, which I will go and get. So here we go, onto the other side, same process. Right, so that's done. Don't forget, front left. So it's ready to go. Go. I'm sure you guys don't want to see me screwing in bolts and nuts. So you get these little strips, feels like rubber, and they slot in, obviously to keep everything else nice and dry, and it also stops it from whistling, so I've been told. And then if you need to add anything onto this rack, then you can just take a little piece out, mark it, cut it, and then put it back in again. Goodness, GoPro is not paying attention today. Right, so there we go. Done. The nut, this one gets screwed in, pushed in like that. There's a funny little key around here somewhere. Oh, I got too much in my pockets. Anyway, and then this one, and that's it locked. Here we go, funny little key goes in there, just locks that. Can't take anything out. Right, we've had really terrible weather for the last couple of days, so let me just show you what I've done while everybody has been. I haven't actually done a lot of filming, but apart from there's a lot of mess in here at the moment, there is a bushwhacker 270 degree awning. I have put walls up at the moment. I've started with the roof that is there for my solar, so I can't finish this at the moment. Some paneling I've done, and what else? So it's bits and pieces at the moment. I've got a new drawer, and then the other day I actually got a rhino rack. Might be a little bit too big, so we're just checking on that at the moment. But that, and there is the rhino bars, and these are now Kaon brackets that I'm putting on. Well, I've just put them on. And these will be for my 270 awning. So the nice thing about the 270 awning is that it will come out to about here, come all the way around, and then it will come all the way through to the back up to here. So we're looking forward to that. And yeah, that's it, guys. Sorry, as I said, it's been lousy weather at the moment. I've just been doing a lot of things in the shed at the moment. There is the fridge is running, the Blue Yeti. Check this idiot. The Blue Yeti's been running the Bushman fridge for the last 5 days, down to about 40% at the moment. I've built a cupboard for the fridge, which will go in, but I can't put it in at the moment until I do the door, the sliding door. So this sliding door over here, I want to completely cover it. As you can see, I've put carpeting down there on the other side. This side has already been sanded, it's already had its first coat of paint. Put a little bit of trim over there. I've already made boxes for the bed. We bought a portaloo the other day, so that will go under the bed. As I said, a little bit dirty at the moment, but I'll be pulling it out. I've got some nice wood for the back. And yeah, as soon as the weather clears up, then I can actually start cutting wood and everything on the outside. It's a little bit difficult at the moment because it keeps on raining and I don't want to get the wood wet and get that damaged. So I'm sorry that I haven't been able to show everybody everything, but yeah, that's everything so far. This is also what I've built. As I said, everything at the moment is running around. This goes in, the fridge goes into there, it goes all the way up to the top. Shelving will be put on from basically from there all the way across into the shed, onto the side of the wall, and then from there kitchen counter and sink and tap and everything. Got a really, really nice tap and sink, so hopefully that's gonna come up as soon as the weather clears up a little bit. Well, take care guys, I will try and update as much as possible, but please understand that I am working basically 5 days a week, so this is dragging out a little bit, but as much as I want it finished, I'd rather do a good job about it. So take care, catch you on the flip side. Cheers.
With that.